Marauders, do you want to learn how to tie the WD40, a killer nymph pattern? We're going to start right now. We're going to use a size 18 to 24. I prefer like a 22. We're tying it to size 18 caddis emerger hook. And we're going to debarb the hook like we always do to start the fly. Now we're going to tie in some light olive 70 denier thread. Now you're going to use wood duck dyed mallard, and you're going to make sure that's long because you're going to wrap it back over for the thorax. So make sure you use a real long feather and just a little bit, because remember, you're tying this in the size 22, 24, 18s. So you're going to tie that in, run the thread back down the bend, and then your wood duck will disappear into your vise. So it's out of the way, and then wrap that up to start the thorax. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to build up a body, because the thread is going to be our main body of our fly. So I'm going to build up a body here. Now we're going to run the thread up to the eyelet, and we're going to start a thorax. And for that, we're going to use a darker olive crystal flash dubbing. As I point to it, I think it's olive sculpin color, but we're going to use that as the thorax area. We're going to dub that in. Now you can stop your eyelet, or your thread, sorry. You can stop your thread right behind the thorax, and you're going to take that wood duck, pull it back to kind of like make a shell, and then tie it down. and then you're going to clip it off as close as you can to the thread, and then go back down the body a couple times to cover all that up and make the body look smooth. You might want to trim them off a little bit of hairs there so that your body of the fly is nice and smooth looking. I don't have any hair sticking out. Now we're going to finish with some whip finishes. And if you watch how I whip finish this fly, I don't build up a bulk place where I put all the wraps of the whip finish. I kind of move them, spread them out, so it keeps doesn't make a bulk in your body. And you go whip finish it, and that's it. It's easy to tie. So when you're tying on size 22 and 24, it's pretty easy. It's not very hard to tie. And it's killer. It works great. What we're going to do here is pick out some of the dubbing and kind of make it look like legs coming from underneath the thorax. I'm going to pick out the bottom of the thorax to bring out some of them hairs. And that is it. Let's take a closer look at this fly right now. Hey, I hope you liked that video. Welcome to the end of the video. Thank you for staying in the whole video. Hope you liked that. Now, you can tie that to represent the betis or a midge. And what we're going to start now is we're going to start all these patterns in a series. So we're going to start with the midges, and we're going to do a worm. Then we're going to do an emerger, and then we're going to do adult, and then we'll go to caddis. We're going to go up through all the flies. I'm going to do many stages of the fly until we get to the big one, the green drake. So that's what we're going to be doing in the next couple weeks. We're probably putting out videos as often as I can. We might have to skip days when it gets warm enough and we go back to work when it's warm enough. When it's cold like today, I think the highs is 22. We're going to be here. And if you want, here's something else I hope you guys are still here. If you are, this is going to be something special for you guys. Up in here or down in the description, I'm going to click a link to a video where you can learn more about midges. He'll explain the different stages of the midges, explain that midges are a burrowing nymph, and they only come out once in a while, and he'll explain all that. And so you can check out his video. I'll put a link, like I said, description below, a link up above. And something new we're going to do at the end of every other videos, so I'm hoping most of you guys are still here, is we're going to feature some of our favorite fellow YouTubers. We're going to tell you which channels we watch and which fly fishing channels we like to watch a lot and I'm subscribed to. So the first one we're going to do is one of my favorites, and it's called The New Fly Fisherman. We're going to put a link. And I think we'll maybe pop up here to a channel quick. We'll put a picture of the channel right here. Okay, welcome back. So there's the New Fly Fisherman. You go check out their channel. Like I said, I'll put a link above and a link below in the description. And that is my first featured channel for you guys to check out. So go check them out. And thank you for being here, Long Rodders. Thank you for watching our videos. And here's some other videos, some earlier. I know I can't say earlier in the week. It's been a long time. We were out deer hunting. I did shoot 150-pound doe. So that's cool. So we got some deer meat coming. I love deer meat. So now we're going to be back. We're done hunting for 2 weeks. We took a little break for the hunting. So now we're back to tying videos. Don't miss. Make sure you subscribe. You can subscribe right down here. And so here's some videos from earlier. Keep your lines wet, out of trees, and only give your them fish a sore lip.